Hi, I'm Nick. In this course, we're going to learn about the broad topic area of machine learning. We'll explore some of the big ideas, and toward the end, we'll even write a little bit of code in Python that can make some intelligent predictions. If you don't know Python already, I highly recommend you start with some of the prerequisites for this course. You'll need to install Anaconda, which is a Python-based platform focused on data science and machine learning. We won't install Anaconda in these videos, so if you haven't installed it already, check out the notes associated with this video for help on how to do that, along with some other Python resources on Treehouse. Machine learning encompasses many different ideas, programming languages, frameworks, and approaches to the subject. So the term machine learning is difficult to define in just a sentence or two. But essentially, machine learning is giving a computer the ability to write its own rules and learn about new things on its own. In this course, you're going to hear a lot of new terms and ideas you may not be familiar with. It's a lot to take in, and you might not understand it all right away. That's normal. I was confused the first time I learned about these concepts. I encourage you to take a look at the teacher notes after each video and watch videos more than once if you feel like you need to. That said, machine learning actually is not as difficult as you might believe, and its applications are far-reaching. You might be surprised where machine learning could show up in your life and how it might be useful to you now and in the coming years. Just to name a few applications, machine learning is already unlocking new possibilities like self-driving cars, digital assistants and chatbots, and new approaches to science and healthcare that can help us dig through vast libraries of complicated information in an instant. Machine learning can be used to create spam filters, search engines that can find your photos based on a text description, and even create original fine art and music. It's putting the power of human reasoning into a computer. In the past, this topic has had other labels like artificial intelligence, and that term still applies here. What's different, however, is that past approaches to machine learning involved a human being writing most or all of the rules. In the mid-90s, the IBM Deep Blue supercomputer famously won a series of chess matches against Garry Kasparov, who many consider to be one of the greatest chess players ever. This is an impressive accomplishment even by today's standards. However, older approaches to artificial intelligence often involved millions of lines of code, writing if statements and conditional logic to guide the computer through an incredible number of small decisions. I'm oversimplifying, but in essence, Deep Blue would look at many branching chess moves into the future, far more than a human can do, and it would pick the best one based on a complicated set of predefined criteria. This type of approach only had the appearance of intelligence, when in reality, most AIs could be distilled down to a giant flowchart created by people. And more importantly, Deep Blue could only play chess. Ultimately, it's more desirable to create a generic machine intelligence that can perform a variety of tasks. Put simply, machine learning is still artificial intelligence, but with a strong focus on the computer's ability to write its own set of rules as it processes more data, rather than humans teaching it everything up front. Using machine learning tools and algorithms, we can explore data in new ways that would otherwise take a ton of work by humans or even by traditional programming or data processing approaches. There's one more thing I need to mention. While this technology has the potential to be more impactful than even the microprocessor or the internet, it also introduces many ethical questions that, over the next few years and decades, will need answers from people like you. This is a huge ongoing discussion on its own, and it's outside the scope of this course, but I highly recommend you check the notes associated with this video for more resources and insight into the ethical and societal implications of machine learning. Now, let's continue with this broad overview by taking a closer look at some of the different approaches to machine learning.